Hey, it's Chris, and today I'm gonna show you a portable triple screen MacBook setup. I'm also gonna show you that Bluetooth mechanical keyboard for Macs that I've been teasing for a few weeks, along with all the other stuff I currently have on my desk. And of course, I'm gonna link all this stuff up in the description so you don't even have to ask. Let's go ahead and start with the most interesting and unique part of this setup, which are those two external monitors that clip onto the MacBook screen. These are 15.6-inch USB-C VinPoc displays, they're 1080p resolution, and they're touchscreen. Now these screens do a lot more than I'm gonna talk about in this video. For instance, you could hook one up to a Nintendo Switch or to certain phones and have them function as a desktop. But we're not gonna cover that today. Now you can grab two of these screens like I have here for about $700 total. And they were actually a little bit cheaper on Indiegogo. Now I'm gonna be 1,000,000% honest with you. Not like I'm ever not. But using these screens has made me feel so much more productive. Like not having to split up my screen between two different apps, for instance, is amazing. Now, I wouldn't say that using these two external monitors clipped to your MacBook Pro's screen is a more beautiful setup with those cords and clips than just using something more elegant and streamlined like an LG UltraWide, for instance. But at the same time, I wouldn't call it ugly either. Now these screens aren't without their quirks. When you plug them in for the first time, they default to like 30% brightness. So you have to turn them all the way up to get the most out of them. And even then, they still aren't as bright as the MacBook screen itself. But as cool as having that extra screen real estate actually is, what's really amazing is that these things are portable. So they come with some magnetic cases that will, number one, protect the screen when you've got it packed up, but number two, double as stands. So if you take this to the coffee shop or you set it up at the hotel desk, you can actually have a triple monitor setup wherever you go. So you might be wondering what is holding up all that weight of the MacBook Pro and these two extra monitors. Well, I got a stand and it's the Curve from 12 South. Now, aside from the fact that this looks great, it looks like a sculpture on your desk and gives you a more comfortable viewing angle and some extra storage that you wouldn't have otherwise underneath, I'm not gonna talk too much about it right now because I'm making a separate video that's gonna come out shortly on the best MacBook stands. So subscribe for that. Now, technically, I actually have a fourth screen in this setup. It's the 11-inch iPad Pro, which if you're a subscriber, you know I already love that device. So in this setup, I've been keeping it off to the right, which of course does let me do some extra multitasking, but it also lets me take advantage of that Apple Pencil when it comes to wanting to sketch or do some handwritten notes or signing a document. Okay, here is finally the moment that so many of you have been waiting for. I'm going to tell you about the mechanical Bluetooth keyboard designed for Macs that I've been teasing and using for a couple of weeks, which also actually comes from VinPoc. If you've never used a mechanical keyboard, you are going to love the clickiness of the keys. It's fun, it's enjoyable, but at the same time, I don't think this is the keyboard that I'm gonna use when it's time to write a novel, for instance. But for casual stuff, like just doing email or whatever, this is great. Aside from the mechanical properties of this keyboard, the other thing that's just great is the light patterns on this keyboard, the RGB backlighting. There's actually 19 patterns for you to choose from, and they're really all very different. So you can kind of have like a rainbow look where it's just switching through all the various colors, or you can have it light up when you tap a key, or it can kind of dart all over the place. There's lots of great options, plenty of variety so it doesn't get old or boring. And yes, when you don't use it for a while, it will shut itself down, it'll go into sleep mode, and when you repress a key, it'll reactivate. So you can kind of save on the battery there, although you could connect it with a cable. I really, really, really like the looks, the aesthetics of this keyboard, and not just the RGB lights either. And so even though Macs aren't known for gaming necessarily, you can bring a little bit of that look and that culture to your setup. This keyboard does have a few quirks. Like it does have a command key, which is great for Mac users, but it doesn't have that symbol. So it's less of a visual way to tell what you're pressing. Also, some of the keys are just weird sizes. Like the right shift key is a square. It's not a rectangle. Just that kind of stuff. Other than that, this thing is compact, it's portable, and you can pair it with up to 3 devices at once. So if you want to pair it with your Mac, but also your iPad, you can do that. So I don't just have one keyboard in this setup, I've actually got 2, and the second one sits right in between the keyboard I just mentioned and my Mac. It's a Loop Deck editing keyboard, and I'm currently in the process of trying to learn how to use it to speed up and give me a better workflow when it comes to video editing in Final Cut Pro and also for photo editing in Photoshop. Now, if you guys want a more in-depth review of the Loop Deck and how it works, then let me know down in the comments. Now, if you have a keen eye, you might have noticed that I've got something that looks a little bit like Apple's canceled AirPower charging mat sitting off to the right of the computer. Well, it's not the AirPower, obviously, but it is similar in the way that it looks and functions. And it lets you charge your iPhone, your Apple Watch, and your wireless AirPods simultaneously. Now, it's pretty easy for a desk setup to start to feel really cluttered really fast when you're talking about as much stuff as we're talking about in this video, and I found that it really helps to have a place for everything to go. So the place for my beloved Bose QC35-2s is the brand new Grovemade walnut headphone stand. Now, this is a leather covered headphone stand with a really sturdy base, and it looks so much better to see my Bose QC35-2s sitting on that rather than a cheap piece of plastic. For storage in this current setup, I'm using a 4 terabyte G Technology external drive. And aside from being USB-C, I also got it because it looks really great sitting next to a Mac. Now, I did something pretty different with how I set this up than anything I've normally done. I partitioned it and I split it right down the middle. So 2 terabytes are just for regular old file storage. The other 2 terabytes are dedicated to Time Machine backups. And so what I've effectively done functionally is get 2 drives for the space of 1. Now, this is a lot of stuff to have plugged in, obviously. So in the background, kind of supporting this crazy mix of stuff, is the brand new 12 South Stego hub. Now, this is a USB-C hub, which has its own USB-C cord stored inside, which is pretty cool, but it's also really small and compact. So it stays out of the way when it's on your desk, but you can also just throw it into your backpack and take it with you because it's just that small. Speaking of hubs, I have another kind of a hub, which is a multi-device charging hub, which I picked up for just $40 on Amazon. And again, I'm gonna link all this stuff up for you down below, which I actually found when I was putting together mysliced.apple.com. There was a wireless chargers slice or collection that I was making, and this was like my favorite one on there, and I decided to order it, and I'm glad that I did. Because none of these kinds of charging hubs are gonna look amazing, but this one looks pretty good for what it is. So you got 4 ports for charging something with a cord, and you've also got 1 spot for charging a phone wirelessly. So 2 final touches that you might have noticed in some of the other shots that I just want to mention real quickly are, number 1, my hand pencil and pen cup holder, which, you know what, even with the Apple Pencil around, there are still times when I need to sign a real document with a pen or something. So I need a place to store that, like a contract, for instance. And what I do is I fill up this hand with coffee beans. And you gotta change it out every now and then, but what it does is make your desk smell amazing. It smells like a coffee shop. Over on the other side of the desk, I also am still using the LeMetric smart clock, and I'm just using it to kind of give me a live count of our YouTube subscribers on the main channel here. And by the way, I say main channel because we just launched a couple other channels. If you wanna check those out and a podcast, then check out the link down below. Now, the desk that this is all sitting on is something that you've probably seen appearing in lots of different videos here on the channel, so I figured I might as well just give it another mention so you know what it is. It's actually the BDI Sequel standing desk, and it's very sturdy, super well made. I love the storage that's built into it as well, because a lot of standing desks don't have any, but I have had to kind of learn to be a little bit careful with the glass top because it does scratch a little bit easily when you have like metal tech stuff clanging around on top. I have been sitting on this equipment for this video, this gear, for what feels like a month or more. And I would love to know what you think about it. Let me tell you what I think about it. You might be wondering if I'm still gonna continue using those 2 external displays now that the video is over And the answer is, yeah, for the time being, I am going to keep using these because, like I said, I just feel so much more productive with them. Now, another question arises, would I rather, as an alternative, use an actual ultra-wide monitor? And I think the honest answer to that is yes, of course, but there's a big but there. You have to look at the price. For $700, you can really extend your productivity. So that wraps it up for this video, but I actually filmed at the same time as I filmed this video, a second video, which is coming out shortly, so make sure you're subscribed, comparing the best MacBook stands. So make sure you're subscribed. Also, don't forget to follow at Daily Tech, spelled Daily TEKK on Instagram and Twitter, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Later.